Welcome to 2K Sports. I'm Damon Bruce. Glad to have you with us. A Sunday broadcast of the NBA. It's going to be Tayshaun Prince and the Detroit Pistons up against the Los Angeles Clippers. And that's it for us in the studio. To call all the action, let's go out to Kevin Harlan and the rest of the 2K Sports crew. I'll see you again at halftime.
Welcome to this Sunday afternoon edition of the NBA here on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. Thanks for joining us. It's Western Conference against the Eastern Conference here in Los Angeles, where the Clippers will try to protect home court. Presented by State Farm, let's take a look now at the Detroit Pistons opening lineup. They've got Jason Maxiel, Rodney Stuckey out there with Brandon Knight. Then there's Tayshaun Prince, and it's Monroe in at the five. And for the Clippers, Blake Griffin and DeAndre Jordan, they're inside. Chris Paul is out there with Chauncey Billups, and it's Butler in at the small forward position.
Well, the Clippers made so much improvement last year, but one area they struggled, they only went 13-17 against the weaker Eastern Conference. So that's a number they'd like to improve upon this year.
Tip-off goes to the Clippers. Paul outside. Butler against Prince. Shots good by Butler. We talk about those Eastern Conference teams and making those road trips to the West. Even the Clippers were not an easy opponent to play for them.
No, not at all. I mean, the Clippers might have been a Cinderella playoff team if they were in the East. I mean, with that 23-18 home record, the West has so much talent. Top to bottom, it's on display every night.
Dishes it to Griffin. He's against Maxiel. Just three to shoot. And that one's good, Griffin.
You know, when you think about it, Blake Griffin, Kevin, has great hands, great skill, and I think he will develop a very good jump shot. Once he gets that, watch out.
We'll go to Doris Burke, who spoke with head coach Lawrence Frank. What's the news, Doris?
Well, guys, he said he doesn't want to see their offense get bogged down tonight. Ball movement, that's the main thing for us. It's been something we've been doing very well, and that's what we're going to concentrate on. Guys?
Good report, Doris. Well said. Thanks. An interesting thing to address before the game.
Yeah, you know, the priority of most coaches is not shooting. I mean, that's really way down the priority list in terms of what a coach might talk about.
Steve?
Well, you don't want to focus on makes and misses because that puts pressure on the players. But clearly, you got to put the ball in the hoop. And I think tonight, making shots from the outside is going to be really key.
And for Blake Griffin, as you said, the potential is there offensively. Steve, he's already devastating.
About 47 points in a game back in January, the most for a player 21 years or younger since Michael Jordan almost three decades ago. So, yeah, Blake Griffin, unlimited potential.
Can't get it to go. Pistons go the other way with the ball. And here is Knight. Here's Stuckey. And Billups picks him up defensively.
Vinny Delnegro didn't have an easy go of it leading the way for the Clippers in his first year coaching that team, but he was able to get them to up their win total, and that's something to build off of.
Here is Knight. Defended by Paul. And taken away by Paul.
He wasn't paying any attention to the defense. Poor pass there.
Outside Butler. Six on the shot clock. guarded by Prince. Blocked. The Pistons trail it. Hangs in the air. Can't get it to go. Solid defense right there from Billups.
Well, getting back to Del Negro, Clark, I mean, this is a team that has a lot of young talent. We've got Blake Griffin to build around. But it's had a losing culture for so long. So this is a tough job. I mean, he's got to really change their style, get them to buy into playing defense and playing together and try to build some momentum with a franchise that really never has had any.
You know, Kevin, one of the things that's sometimes overlooked with Billups, he's strong at 6'3 and 200 pounds plus, but he's an excellent low post player for a guard.
Johnson's Billups. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one. And Clark, you talk about Billups' great post-up ability. He may be slowing down with age, but Steve, that post-up game of his is timeless.
Yeah, 6'3", as Clark mentioned, a really strong body. And he's got good footwork, great touch, just a good knack for scoring. He's one of the better post-up point guards in the NBA today. Well, it was a major struggle for Detroit, as you would expect, against the strong Western Conference last season. They really struggled when they went away from the East.
Now here's Prince, looking for his first bucket of the game. Stuckey against Billups. Trying to get back on track. A nice shot by Knight. But, you know, for the Pistons in the Western Conference, Clark, not a big deal right now. But eventually they're going to have to obviously improve in that area when they are approaching the playoffs.
Yeah, you know, 8 wins last year and 9 the year before. I mean, they've got bigger issues they've got to deal with.
They got to win at home. They got to win in their conference or division. I mean, you know, first things first.
That's right. Well said.
Here's Griffin. Brandon Knight picking up that last basket. He tries for 3. Can't get it to go. So Detroit will take it the other way. Prince backing him down. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it 3.
Got the shot to drop and has a chance for one more.
Boy, that was a tidy little play that time by him to get a chance at 3 points.
Well, Tayshaun Prince was once a lockdown defender, but he's sustained some back injuries over time, and that slowed him down a little bit, but he's still a very effective player.
Talking about Prince, even those injuries you mentioned, he still has that incredible reach working for him defensively.
Well, the wingspan of a condor, I call it, and clearly that is always going to be there. It's not going away. He may get a little slower, but he will always be long, and that's a useful attribute to have defensively.
And here are the Pistons now, following the shot by Caron Butler. Stuckey. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a 3-point play. The Clippers making a switch here. Young's checked in.
And for the Pistons, like a lot of young teams, it was a real struggle last season on the road. In fact, they only won 9 times away from their home building.
Free throw no good for Stuckey. Steve, going back to those 9 wins on the road for Detroit you just talked about, Clark, just not a pretty sight when they traveled away from the Motor City.
Well, the issue for Detroit was offensively. They just didn't have any kind of consistency or continuity. I mean, they could not successfully put together strong offensive showings, especially on the road. And I think you've got to score better on the road than you do at home. Mm-hmm. I think typically you play a little better defensively at home. On the road, you've got to be ready to score the ball.
He passes to Yurepko. Stuckey. Prince with it. Shoots. And again, it's the Pistons missing.
Well-contested shot there.
And that's the key defensively. You've got to make them work for it. Challenge every shot.
Here's Paul, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
I'll tell you what, you watch this guy put it in the basket, and his scoring ability can just astound you at times.
Now Stuckey, now the dish to Knight. Chris Paul covering. Knight kicks to Prince. Young against Stuckey. Over Young. Stuckey can't get it to go. The Clippers in the lead. And he's knocked off course by the D. The foul called. He'll shoot free throws.
Kevin, interesting story with Caron Butler. He's out of Racine, Wisconsin, and had a rough childhood, but really a great story of a guy turning things around for himself. He's been one of the more consistent players in the league.
And the first one at the line is good. Mark, you're right about Caron. He's had a fascinating life, a lot of ups, but a lot of downs to begin things. Steve, twice selected an All-Star back in 07 and 08, but over the last few seasons, injuries have slowed him down.
Yeah, so tough last year, Dallas, in the midst of that great season that they enjoyed, to lose Caron Butler. Boy, you hated to see that happen. And now Butler getting into his 30s. It's tougher and tougher to bounce back from injuries. So hopefully he'll be able to come back and continue to play at a high level. We'll see.
And the Pistons decide to take their first timeout right here.
Now the Clippers are such a young, exciting team. And last season they went 23-18 at home at the Staples Center. This is a team with a very bright future, and they'd like to establish that home court.
Here's Bynum. Under 6 minutes left in the first quarter of the game. For those Los Angeles fans, Clark, the emergence of Blake Griffin as a superstar has to be a cause for celebration. Steve talked about their winning record at home, over 500. I've got this team circled. What about you?
Yeah, I do too. And part of the reason is the guy in the middle. I mean, there's a feeling this team is only going to get better, and Griffin may quickly become L.A.'s most dominant basketball player. He's certainly already perhaps the most hyped and closing in on maybe as popular as Kobe Bryant in some sort.
He's something else.
Yeah, he's special to watch.
Here's Paul following the bucket by the Pistons. Butler on the wing. Parton the screen. Shot clock at 6. Butler against Prince. Butler, a well-timed shot fake, got the defender off the ground right there.
Wow, has he caught fire this quarter, shooting the ball with tremendous confidence.
Now here's Stuckey. Up with it. Gets it to fall. Stuckey's got 6.
You know, it's a plus to get good looks in the paint, and when you can get them, you got to score them.
Griffin a screen on Bynum. Picked by Griffin. And here is Paul. Martin with a screen on Prince. Prince against Butler. Paul with the 3. Paul left side. Right side Griffin. Covered by Monroe. Outside, Martin. Butler on the wing. Over Prince. And Butler gets it to go on the assist by Martin. 10 points for Butler.
I think he set in tone for the entire team in this quarter. Tremendous stuff. Good action.
Prince backing him down. And him against Paul. Here is Bynum. Defended by Paul. Takes a 3. Bynum, no good.
They are setting the tone here early with their work on the boards.
And only a moderate advantage here, a slight one, but as the game went on, it's one they'll definitely look to build on.
What a streak he's on. He's just one of those guys who can really catch fire.
Great offensive performance they're putting on.
You see the benefit of knocking down baskets consecutively because it leads to the confidence growing and growing, doesn't it, Steve?
It sure does, and now it's to the point where they just feel unstoppable.
Now a timeout called by Detroit.
And guys, coming into last season, there were a lot of question marks about Chris Paul. He had that knee injury, and I thought at times last year it really showed. He was hobbled, but he still has the ability to be one of the most dominant point guards in the NBA. He still put up big numbers for the Hornets.
DeAndre Jordan's check in for Griffin. Evans comes in for Kenyon Martin. And Mo Williams subbed in for Caron Butler. Then for the Pistons, Ben Wallace, he's checked in for Monroe. Gordon comes in for Rodney Stuckey. And Knight subbed in for Will Bynum. Here is Knight. Five to shoot. With the clock winding down. A second chance effort. Wallace misses.
Seems like he tightens up, guys, when he gets close to the rim, especially with a defender nearby.
Gordon against Paul. Back to Young. Guarded now by Tayshaun Prince. Over Wallace. And again, the Clippers good for two.
Just trying to wear them down here.
Yeah, the lead is just expanding right now. Just what you want to do when you've got a team down. Don't let them up.
Paul against Gordon. Yurepko inside. He goes up. That's blocked. And the shot clock expires. 24-second violation. There's a minute 40 left in the first quarter. Ball against Gordon. And Young kicks to Evans. Six to shoot. Pass to Paul. Fades and shoots. And the Clippers getting another bucket right there. Here is Knight. It's a 9-point spread. Paul against Gordon. Chris Paul covering. He couldn't stay in bounds, and that's going to be a turnover.
Man, another mistake. This is embarrassing. I mean, you've got to make better decisions than that.
And here are the Clippers. They're on a 16-4 run. Young with the ball. Guarded by Prince. The kick out to Williams. Jordan against Wallace. Williams up on top. Clock at six. The Clippers need to get off a shot. Here's Jordan. Off target there. That would have pushed the lead to double digits. Gordon the pass to Knight. Back to Gordon. Defended by Paul. Here's Prince. No good trying to beat the buzzer. And that concludes the first quarter of play. Clippers lead by 9.
So difficult to get a shot off against this defense. They are really playing hard.
Yeah, they're playing hard and they pride themselves on making it tough for their opponents.
More great action when we return.